desperate and broken. The sound of a fight. Father has spoken.
I gotta stop before I cry.
Please do, because I'm actually shedding a tear behind these.
Let's talk about all this touring that you've been doing for the last months. Because I saw you guys play Wembley, which was great. Not the side of the stage, but close to. Very bright, lots of screaming. Saw you dive in.
Lots of screaming, exactly.
Lots of screaming. Too much screaming. I'm like, shut up, I can't hear him sing.
Oh, come on.
How much more time are you spending this year on the road, like proper touring, like your own shows, not festivals?
Pretty much the rest of this, for the majority of the year, is our own shows, just a few more festival dates, and we don't ship home until December 19th.
Just in time for Christmas.
Just in time.
You've got your O2, you've announced your O2 show in London.
Yep.
Very exciting.
It's almost sold out.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Are you going to change the format of the shows, especially for O2?
I'm sure we will.
It's going to be a complete reinvention of what we've done in the past.
Yeah.
It will be a definite change of the guard, and we're revisiting the entire set.
What was the idea behind getting all these people to you just grabbed random strangers, or is this another selection process?
I mean, at some point, Jared just started kind of interviewing people. I don't know that if you really had that idea necessarily from the start, but he started interviewing people every night.
Oh, yes, he did.
Oh, well, maybe he did. To me, it didn't seem like it. But then all of a sudden, you know, there was loads of cool interviews with these amazing kids, you know, or people, not just kids, I mean, just individuals. And then he started inserting them into the video, and it was really cool.
My philosophy in life is don't regret anything you do. Because in the end, it makes you who you are.
Did you have any idea that it would end up being quite as successful? Because to cut up your songs like that, because every time someone talks, it cuts out. Did you ever think, well, you know, it's our song and we want to do it, you know, as a straight video? Are you quite happy to just have it? Because it's quite very unconventional.
I don't know if he's really thinking about that, you know? I think it's more about, like, that is its own project. It's not just about the song, you know? It's about the visual as well. So it's not necessarily like, okay, the song has to be there and then we'll fit the images around that. I think it's more about making it into one project. Would you say so?
Very well said.
The live footage that's in the video, is this coming from the Into the Wild DVD? Is that all winged? Are you just pulling bits?
I mean, it's all from that type of footage. I think probably you could say that it's like a small glimpse into what it might be like. Or maybe not.
There's a lot of fans that are really eager to see this DVD. Actually, we talked about Artifact last time I saw you guys. Is that close to completion? Done? Edited? Finished?
Should be.
But?
I think we're going to try and premiere it at Sundance if we get accepted into that festival.
Exactly.
What is the idea? Is it covering from the very start of the album up until the tour finishing?
Yeah, and the Into the Wild DVD takes care of the live road and everything from the first shows.
What do you think fans will get from seeing Artifact? Is it
a glimpse into what we went through in 2008 and 2009 where we were making our record, This Is War?
But is it really personal? Like, are you letting people really into your heart?
I think so. I mean, they're seeing us like how we are.
Yeah. It's quite
seeing him doing like all the stuff that he does throughout a day. Like, you get to see a day in the life of like the madman. You know what I mean?
Is that your unofficial title, the madman?
Yes.
I think so.
Dr. Madman.
I like Dr. Strangelove, but more modern.
That's right.
If anyone thought that there wasn't a lot going on, they'll be quickly reminded.
Do you feel comfortable with that much of it? Because obviously musicians always put themselves out there on record. But having that actually filmed, you know, cameras in your face all the time.
You got used to it really quickly, and it started to become just a thing in the background.
Did you never turn around and go, whoa, hello, what are you doing there?
Not really.
Shannon didn't like it very much, but I think now it would be different.
Yeah, it would be
now
totally
people
different.
People understand the process a little bit more. People would be a little more comfortable. And we do all the editing in-house. We have people there. It's not like footage is floating around the university.
Yeah.
So it's very safe.
Out on the road and you've been out on the road forever, how do you kind of stay sane? Because a lot of bands go out there and they go, I don't know what day it is, I don't know what month it is, where the hell are we waking up today?
I think that we kind of enjoy that and embrace that whole journey. I mean, it's pretty awesome.
Are you still getting out into each city and having a bit of a nosy round?
No, not always. No. Because some days you're too busy, but that's okay. I mean, you're there to do other things. You know, we're there to play shows and to like have these experiences with people.
Has there been one show that stood out in particular?
Not just one, but there's been a couple that are memorable. I mean, Rock and Ring was pretty amazing. Download was amazing. There was a show in Switzerland called Caravana Festival that was incredible. Really fun. And then all of our headlining shows.
What makes a show truly great?
I think just when everything clicks, when the audience is electric and the band is tight and we're all connected together. When it's like a universal thing, that makes a show.
Festival-wise, you've done Download. How do you approach a festival crowd? Is it any different to your own shows?
Well, it is different from our own shows because there's a lot of different people there, but I don't know if we approach it any differently. I mean, we go on stage the same way every night with the same intention of just like putting on a great show and, you know, making people have a great night.
Because most bands play shorter set lists, get that one out, a bit of tongue tie. How do you choose which ones you want to play? Is it just a best of? You're like, everyone knows this one, everyone knows that one, and this one will get the crowd going and just chop, 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 chop.
No, we have set lists as like guidelines, but they often change while we're playing the show.
How do you communicate that? Like, were you just a bit of a wink? Yeah. Bit of sign language going on.
You just kind of, I don't know, you just kind of know after a while.
Okay.
It's a bit of magic mojo.
Yeah.
Really? Not just like third eye transmissions?
Sort of like that. You learn each other's things, and then you can, like, sometimes you can tell what song he's going to go into before he even says anything, just by like...
They know you too well.
It's true though, I mean, it's like that. And then everyone's like... Ready.
And it's the pose.
Yeah.
All right, well, this was just a very quick interview, but just to say hello and check in and see how you're going.
How are you doing? Closer to